As the technology progressed, the launch sites became more complex.
In Kansas, there were 12 missile silos that were built around Schilling Air Force Base.
The most advanced of the Atlas series, the Atlas F complex, is one of the strongest structures ever built. Its walls were constructed out of heavily reinforced concrete.
The silo is a steel structure. You've got 3-inch thick rebar and over 600 tons of metal that was put in place. And then concrete was poured down and encapsulated all of that steel structure. And that concrete has a special epoxy resin in it. So it was a much stronger concrete. This was known as a hardened site. It could withstand a nuclear strike within a mile radius.
Unlike its predecessors, the Atlas F missile, armed with a thermonuclear warhead, was designed to be housed in deep, hardened underground silos.
It was stored vertically in a silo. The silo goes down 176 feet deep, and it had 75-ton blast doors that would open up, an elevator would lift it to the surface, and then it would launch off.
The high-security underground complex was spread out over 12 floors and consisted of a launch control center, which was connected via tunnel to the main missile silo.
As you would come down the staircase, first you would come to this, which is known as the entrapment area. You would be buzzed in with electronic locks. And once this door shut, then you would pick up a phone, look into a camera, and say the password to be able to get in. If you said the right password, the next door would be electronically unlocked and you would be able to go through. After you go through the entrapment door, you would come across these 2 1-ton blast doors. The blast door was made of manganese. It has a higher melting point than regular steel.
In the event the silo was damaged by a nuclear strike, engineers devised a clever strategy to maintain its structural integrity. The walls and the floor don't join together. They're entirely separate from each other.
As you can see, there's a gap here, and it was suspended from the ceiling. You see this bracket here? You had a compressed air system which would stabilize the whole floors. So that if a nuclear blast did happen and this entire place was shaking, everything would be safe inside. Even the lights are on springs.
By November 1964, the US government announced that all first generation ICBMs, including the Atlas, would be retired the following year. By 1965, Air Command decommissioned all Atlas F missiles and stripped each launch site of its salvageable materials. But that wasn't the end of the Atlas silos. Currently, Matthew is overseeing the redevelopment of a former Atlas F missile base. His plan is to turn it into a fully self-sustainable facility, which could be used for space colonization training projects.
So this is the launch control desk. Unfortunately, when it was decommissioned, they gutted out the desk completely so that it could never be used again. Ultimately, my goal is to probably cut this out, put in a touchscreen monitor, and digitally recreate what the launch control desk used to look like.
Yet Matthew isn't the only developer looking to take these silos into the 21st century.
Welcome to the survival condo.
The Atlas F missile silos, made of reinforced concrete and steel, were designed to withstand a 10 kiloton nuclear explosion. Yet as technology evolved, the launch sites became obsolete. Now, more than 50 years after they were decommissioned, some developers jumped at the chance to purchase these properties.
I originally purchased this particular site in 2008. We built it so that families would have a place protected against a nuclear blast, tornadoes or hurricanes, even things like nerve gases and more deadly man-made things.
Engineer and software developer Larry Hall was looking to establish a luxury subterranean dwelling. And the colossal infrastructure of this abandoned Cold War Atlas nuclear missile silo made it the ideal location.
Once you have a nuclear-hardened structure that you start with, you've got a huge cost advantage. We're starting with a structure that if I had to duplicate would cost about $131 million. Each floor is a little over 2,200 square feet, and there's 15 stories. So this whole facility with the dome that we added over 20,400 square feet gives it a total of 54,000 square feet of protected space.
Just like the original structure, the walls of the silo have been redesigned to protect against disaster.
This outer wall is 18 inches thick, but it's got 45 feet of reinforced concrete and rock stacked outside of it to form a wedge. So a shockwave would approach that wedge, acts like an airfoil, and it takes the blast up and over the facility.
This facility had a requirement to withstand a shockwave that would travel just over 2,000 miles per hour.
If you compare that to the strongest F5 tornado that recorded speeds of 304 miles per hour, an F5 tornado wouldn't scratch the paint on this place.
Evidence of the silo's military past is gone, and the stark concrete underground bunker is now equipped with modern survival gadgets. The 15-story inverted skyscraper has been transformed. Larry worked with a NASA psychologist to combat the mental strain that living underground may have on people.
We have high-definition cameras mounted outside the facility that provide a live feed, so you can look to see what time of day it is and what the weather's doing, who's coming and going, but it just connects you.
NASA also inspired the way in which food is supplied and stored so deep underground.
Welcome to hydroponics level 4. This is the area we grow our fresh fruits and vegetables. We can outproduce lettuce 40-1 versus soil growth outside. You also get therapy from working with plants, having live things growing around you. People really appreciate it.
Many crucial life support systems have been implemented to make sure people can survive underground. There is a military-grade nuclear, biological, and chemical air filtration system that processes just over 2,000 cubic feet per minute.
All of the incoming air goes through a series of these three gigantic NBC nuclear, biological, and chemical air filters. These filter every known pathogen to man, including things like weaponized nerve gas, like a mustard gas or a chlorine gas.
Once the residents are inside and fully protected, they can unwind by the pool.
The saltwater pool. It's got a waterfall and a slide for the kids. It's all computer controlled. There's a computer that literally keeps the chemicals perfect in it. It's all geothermally heated and cooled.
From nuclear bomb shelter to luxury survival condos, this subterranean structure has evolved. Hopefully, the silo will never face a true catastrophe. But just in case, they'll be prepared.